your choice, a cockroach or a congressman? Public policy polling says 85% of voters view Congress very negative. In fact, time-honored favorites like cockroaches, root canals, traffic jams, and NFL replacement refs are now more popular than Congress. Joining me now, I've got two freshman legislators, Republican Congresswoman Ann Wagner and Democratic Congressman Matt Cartwright. And first to both of you, congratulations. You are now members of most likely the most hated legislative body in U.S. history. Congresswoman Wagner, I know that you come from the private sector. You're brand new to Washington. You're going to be on House Financial Services. What do you want to change?
There's so much that has to be changed. And, you know, I'm not surprised at these numbers from the American people. We've got an approval rating in Congress that's basically tantamount to the margin of error. And it's because we're not getting anything done. We've been sent to this 113th Congress, Cheryl, with a mandate from the people to cut spending, rein in this debt, and attack the big things, the hard things, like entitlement reform. Some 72% of Americans are ready for us to talk about this debt crisis that we're in by attacking the big things like entitlements.
You know, Congressman Cartwright, your party, the Democrats, when the issue of cutting entitlements comes up, I mean, there's a collective sigh and gasp among your party. Do you think it's possible that entitlement reform can get back on the table in the Democratic Party?
Well, first, I want to agree with Ann when I say that all of us, we have about 85 of us, freshman congressmen, about 49 Democrats, 35 Republicans. We all come to Congress knowing full well that we've had such low approval ratings in Congress that we have to do something differently. And I think the first thing that we mean to do is to get together and get to know each other, and at least on a social level to begin with, because we intend to do that. In fact, Luke Messer and I, Luke is the elected president of the Republican freshman class.
Okay.
He and I got together this past Sunday night. We were at a Congressional Research Service seminar down in Williamsburg, Virginia. We got together and we addressed all of the freshmen together, and we stood there right next to each other at the microphone and said, we understand this problem with the perception of Congress.
But entitlement reform, Congressman Cartwright, I mean, that is a big, I mean, many investors are they said that that's the biggest issue they have is entitlement programs, and that they've got to be addressed. Can we cut those budgets? Is it possible?
Everything's on the table. There are certainly some things that are more important than others, but right now we're facing a crisis. We're coming into a time when we have to raise the debt ceiling. It is absolutely vital that we do not hold a debt ceiling hostage the
sure.
way it was done last year. In
sure.
fact, Dr. Douglas Holtz Aiken at the CRS seminar, he's a top Republican economist.
Yeah, we know very well.
He
mm-hmm.
said, you cannot hold the debt ceiling hostage.
But it's going to happen, and it's going to happen. And Congressman Cartwright, I want to take that to Congresswoman Wagner, because as you're well aware, this debate is coming on the debt ceiling fight. You're going to be very involved in that. What do you think that you can do, Congresswoman Wagner, to advance the debt ceiling debate in the right direction for the country?
Absolutely. Any discussion, Cheryl, about the debt ceiling must include spending cuts, a serious discussion and movement and action about spending cuts and reforms that are going to reduce our debt. The American public are tired of us kicking the can down the road. They're tired of a do-nothing Congress. We have a Senate that hasn't passed a budget in over 4 years. You know, we learned today that for the fifth year running, we've got a deficit now for the fifth year in a row of over $1 trillion. That's unsustainable. It's immoral. It's wrong for the future of our children. And as a mother of three and, you know, a protector of America's future, we are going to attack this debt ceiling crisis and make sure that we get to the bottom of all of it and as we move forward.
Well, Congressman Wagner and Congressman Cartwright, I say this in all honesty, good luck to the both of you in the 113th Congress. We're going to be watching. Thank you.
Thanks, Cheryl.